Well, it's an honor to have a man on this program I've been watching from afar, keeping my eye on, Chalres Djou, who's running for the House in Hawaii. I think the 1st District, right, sir?
Yes, that's right. Aloha, Mark. Thank you very much for having me on your show.
Well, it is a great honor and a great pleasure, and you have a real shot at this thing, and I want people to know that there is this special election going on. 317,000 ballots were mailed out on April 30, 120,000 have returned. That means there's a lot of ballots out there for conservatives who still need to return them, and I want to make sure they return them for you, Chalres.
Yes, absolutely. You know, Mark, this is a historic and really exciting election. I mean, not only is it a special election coming up, and the election was on May 22nd, just in a little over a week here in Hawaii, but this is a real compelling election for the country. If we're able to win this race in the president's hometown, it will send a signal that not a single Democratic seat is safe in this country, and it'll set up the Republicans really well for taking back a majority in the U.S. House this coming November. And I'm very, very excited about this race. Everybody says Hawaii is this deep blue state. No way a Republican can win. But you know what? We're on the cusp of doing exactly that here in this special election in just 8 days.
You're a very exciting candidate, and I'm going to tell you why. Not only because you're really swimming against the heavy Democrat numbers in Hawaii, but you know you're articulate, you're unabashed, you're out there talking about issues like liberty and private property rights and limited government and the Constitution. How's that going over in your state, in your district?
Very well, you know, Mark, and thank you very, very much for those very kind words. You know, I tell people here that Republicans are talking about here, about being responsible with taxpayer money, that the government, the federal government, they're spending too much of our money. Even worse, they're spending too much of our money on programs that aren't working. And even worse than that, the fact that we have no plan to pay back any of this money other than to hand the bill off to our nation's children. That is a message which is resonating in all 50 states of our nation, including the state of Hawaii. And I and my campaign is proving exactly that.
Now, you are or were an officer in the Army Reserve, right?
Yes, yes, I still am. I still am an officer in the Army Reserve, and it's been a great honor to wear the uniform and serve the country.
But tell us more about your background.
Yeah, I'm currently a member of the Honolulu City Council. Before I was on the City Council, I was a member of the Hawaii State House of Representatives, where I was the Republican floor leader. Outside of the Council, as we mentioned, I'm an officer in the Army Reserve, and I'm actually a professor also at the University of Hawaii. But most of all, out of all my jobs, the single most important job I have isn't councilman, it isn't Army Reserve officer, and it isn't college professor. The most important job I have in my life is being a good husband and a great dad to my three wonderful children.
And you have a beautiful family. I'm looking at a photograph of your family right now, and I guess they're all excited too, right?
Mark, I think they are excited for this to finally be over. We are coming in on the home stretch of this special election, and I think we're all excited for being over, excited to make history.
You know what I've always wondered, as a side point, if you represent Hawaii in Washington, that is a hell of a long flight back and forth. I mean, my God, how do you do that all the time?
I guess you have to have a lot of stamina and build up a lot of freaking flyer miles between the 50th state and Washington D.C. But no, it's important. It's an important job, and it's important that we really focus on changing the direction of our United States Congress. And we can do exactly that here in the state of Hawaii in just 8 days. And I, Mark, thank you very much for giving me this audience with your listeners, and I really want to emphasize, I need your help. We really, really can win this race. The polls look really good, but I still need your help to seal this deal and really capture this seat and send this huge message that even here in Hawaii, a seat which has been held by Democrats for 20 years, a seat which is the hometown of the President of the United States, that even here, a Republican with a message of fiscal responsibility and government accountability is a message that resonates and can win.
Now, you're still running ads, I take it, to try and get out the vote?
Yes, I am. We're fighting to the very, very end with this race. Every vote counts, and we are working hard right now.
So you still need donations, right?
Yes, of course, Mark. You know, we're not letting up right now. It is a little bit unique for special elections in the state of Hawaii. Special elections are 100% mail-in elections. Mm-hmm. But we will fight all the way up to the very end on May 22nd, and we are eagerly looking forward to making a statement to our Congress, making a statement to our nation, that the current majority in Congress is taking our country in the wrong direction, and we need to change that.
Now, if people want to donate, they can go to your website, djou.com.
Yes, right. You can find out more information about my background, more bunch information about this campaign, and, of course, if you can help me out, please, yeah, do visit my website, djou.com. That's my last name, djou.com.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to take a look. We're going to try and give you all the support we can, sir, because we want you in Congress. Now, let me ask you this quickly.
Yeah.
Would you vote to repeal, if you could, the government-run health care?
Yes, absolutely. Spending $1 trillion and raising taxes by $600 billion in the middle of an economic recession in and of itself is a bad idea. But even worse than that here, we passed a bad idea that is not going to fix our problems with national health care in America. What we need to do is we need to be doing a lot of other things, like looking at medical malpractice reform, allowing the interstate sale of health insurance, and pushing for individual ownership instead of corporate ownership of health care plans. That's sensible reforms that will work and that we need, not this $1 trillion plan that Congress just passed last month.
And am I right that Hawaii has to rely on energy that's basically imported?
Yes.
Under the island. So you would oppose cap and trade too, I take it.
Yes, that's correct, Mark. You know, Hawaii, we're the only state in the union that does not generate any fossil fuels on our own. So all of our energy usage, all of this capital is shipped out of Hawaii. But, you know, more generally for our nation, we purchase so much of our fossil fuels from countries which aren't real favorable to our values of liberty and democracy. It's important we get a sensible energy policy in that expands the domestic supply of energy rather than trying to rely on what Congress is currently proposing, which is a de facto tax on all of the American people with this cap-and-trade system.
I'm going to tell you why, or tell my audience why your election is also crucial. You don't even have to comment on that. You have two aging senators. I mean, they're really up there. And if we can get you into the House where you can build a record, a solid record, one day we may actually get you into the Senate, or the folks may actually get you into the Senate. So I don't want you to jump ahead, but I'm telling people, this is how you build a farm team. This is how you crack the establishment. This is how you take back your government, by electing somebody like you.
Yes. Mark, thank you very much. I appreciate your confidence in me and perhaps one day running for the U.S. Senate, but I'll tell you the reality is my focus is on winning this special election on May 22nd, and we really can do it if I can get the support of your listeners here. We really can make a defining statement election here in just 8 days out here in Hawaii.
All right. Well, God bless and good luck to you, my friend.
Hey, thank you so much, and aloha to everybody out there. Don't forget, djou.com, djou.com, and Mark, next time, let's do this interview in Honolulu on Waikiki Beach.
Oh, my God. You'd have to keep me away. Yes, we'll do that.
Sounds good.
All right. Take care. He's a good man. You see his enthusiasm? He's very charismatic. He's young. He's enthusiastic. He's in the military. He's a solid conservative. Exactly the kind of people we need to support. And I would urge you to do it. I don't care where you live, where you're from, what your background is. This is a national legislature, the Congress. All of these members are our congressmen and congresswomen. It's true. They all vote on these bills, in addition to your own member. So Chalres Djou, djou.com, djou.com, that's his website. You can contribute to his campaign. And the goal now is to get people with these ballots to vote for him. It's a special election. 317,000 ballots were mailed out on April 30th. 120,000 have been returned. It's a lot of ballots that aren't back yet, and they have until May 22nd. And the results will be announced on May 22nd. So they have to be in by May 22nd. So if you know anybody in Hawaii, or they hear us in Hawaii, which they do, don't sit back. You got to vote. And if more of us vote, more of you vote, we win and they lose.